A user asked me on Messenger how to install n8n on a VPS. Let me show you how to take control. No more paying for n8n subscriptions. This is your server, your setup, your rules. In this tutorial, you'll build, launch, and own your n8n platform. To keep things smooth and hassle-free, I recommend using the same VPS I'm using. Some providers block essential ports, offer weak specs, or charge way too much. The one I use is fast, reliable, and affordable. It just works. You'll find the link and all the commands you need down in the description. Let's go. Let's open the browser and head to the page. You'll find the link in the description below. Now let's click Get Started and choose a plan. Let's scroll down slightly, you'll see several VPS plans available. For personal automation projects, the first plan is more than sufficient. With 3 vCPUs and 8 GB of RAM, it offers a solid foundation. If you're building a SaaS or running more demanding workloads, I recommend starting with the second plan or higher. For this demonstration, we'll go with the first plan and click Install VPS. Let's change the country and set the currency to USD. Let's also switch this to monthly. You can keep it on yearly if you want an additional discount. For storage, I prefer NVMe for its speed. If you need more space, you can choose SSD instead. Both options are solid. For the image, let's click on Apps and Panels and select Docker with Ubuntu 22. This will automatically install Docker for us. Let's scroll down a bit more. Here we need to set the root password for the VPS. This is the password you'll use to connect to your server. Make sure to save it somewhere safe and don't forget it. You'll definitely need it later. Let's click Next. And here, if you're new, you're asked to create an account. Be sure to enter accurate information. Since I already have an account, I'll just log in. This feature is important. It's the backup option. You can enable it to avoid losing important files, and it only costs a few extra dollars. But since this is just a demonstration, I'm not adding it. Everything looks good, so let's click Order and Pay. The payment is complete, and since I already have an account, the VPS was likely delivered instantly. If it's your first time, no stress. You might just need to go through a quick account verification. Now, head over to your inbox. You should see a few emails, one confirming your order, one from PayPal, and the key one, your server credentials. Open that one, copy the IP address of your VPS, and keep it close. We're about to use it. To connect to your server, we'll use a tool called PuTTY. Just type PuTTY into Google. Click the top result and grab the 64-bit version. The installation is simple. Nothing tricky. Before we connect, we'll come back to that in a moment. First, let's point our subdomain to the VPS. Open your browser and head over to Cloudflare. Select your domain name then click on DNS. Click Add Record, and here I recommend typing automation and pointing it to your VPS IP, though you can choose any subdomain you prefer. If you'd rather use your main domain, just type @. Using a subdomain is generally better for organization. Then click Save. Now, let's connect to the VPS. Go ahead and open PuTTY. Paste the VPS IP into the hostname field. You can name the session whatever you like. I'll go with n8n automation. Click Save so it's there for next time. Then hit Open and let's jump in. The first time you connect, you'll see a security warning. Just click Accept. Here, we need to enter the VPS username and password we set during the purchase. The username is root by default, and the password is the one I asked you to save earlier. Let's start by installing Portainer. This will give us a simple interface to manage containers. Just copy and paste the commands I have here in the editor. Quick and easy. Let's move on to the next step. Now enter this address in your browser to access Portainer. Just make sure to replace this IP with your own VPS IP. Now let's copy the address, paste it into the browser, and hit Enter. Now it's time to set up the admin account. To make things clearer, let's enter the username and password right here in the editor. Let's type a strong random password, something secure enough to protect our setup. Now let's copy the password and paste it into the appropriate fields twice. Then click Create User. Let's click Get Started. Then Local. Go to Stacks and click Add Stack. Now let's copy the name n8n stack. You can name it whatever you like. And now let's also copy the stack configuration, the Docker Compose code. But before you paste it, don't forget, it's very important to update a few things. Make sure to set your own username and choose a secure password. Also, set the hostname to match the subdomain you configured in Cloudflare. And don't miss the webhook URL. It should include your hostname and end with a slash. If you skip any of these, the setup simply won't work. Now let's copy the entire Docker Compose configuration and paste it into the appropriate field. Scroll down and click Deploy the stack. This will take a few minutes as it sets up the required containers in the background. Done. Let's click on Containers to check if everything is running correctly. And great. Everything seems to be working just fine. Let's fix the volume permissions now by copying and pasting this command into the terminal. Now for the final step, let's access NGINX Proxy Manager so we can make n8n accessible through the browser using our domain. To access NGINX Proxy Manager, copy and paste this URL into your browser. Take a moment here. Make sure to replace the IP with your actual VPS IP address. If you skip this step, the page won't load. Now let's copy and paste the default login credentials for NGINX Proxy Manager. Email admin@example.com. Password, change me. Make sure to log in right away and change the password to something secure. Let's enter the following details. Full name. Your full name as you want it to appear. Nickname. A short name or username. Email address. A valid email you'll use for notifications and recovery. Take your time to make sure everything is correct before moving on. For clarity, I'm going to write both the email and the password right here in the editor. Click Save. For the password, let's type a long random one, something strong and secure. Let's copy the password and paste it into both fields. Now let's go to Hosts, then Proxy Hosts, and click Add Proxy Host. Let's enter the subdomain. It's the one we configured earlier in Cloudflare, remember? Let's keep the scheme set to HTTP. In the forward hostname, paste n8n. And for the port, enter 5678. Let's enable WebSockets and block common exploits for extra security. In the SSL tab, request a new certificate and make sure force SSL, HTTP2 support, and HSTS are all enabled. Let's agree to the Let's Encrypt terms by toggling on the option right here. Click Save. And you're done. Let's now access our n8n instance and check if everything is working properly. And here we are, n8n is up and running. Let's fill in the details. Email, first name, last name, and a secure password. There's a quick survey. Feel free to answer however you like, it won't affect the setup. And here we are. Everything is running just as it should. Let's try creating a workflow to make sure everything works. Let's add a webhook. And as you can see, everything works as expected. And just like that, n8n is up, running, and fully yours. No subscriptions, no restrictions, full control right on your own VPS. If you made it this far, congrats. You've built your own automation powerhouse. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment if this helped. See you in the next one.